teacher forgets, you have to remind him. Okay, so for the B section, we had a detailed discussion class on introduction and the syllabus, all these things. So same I will take for the A section some other time, but as today the class is combined, so let me start the syllabus direct. Syllabus also I mentioned, and in detail I explained the syllabus also for the B section students. So those, all these things, what is it's important of geotech, I will tell you for the A section in some other class. So now coming to the syllabus. So first topic, basic topic is, what is soil mechanics, definition of soil mechanics, and most importantly, what are its applications? What are its applications? Okay, so now, first of all, what is the most important application of soil? Let mute karunga konayat Dipti. Okay, okay, the most important application of soil is for farmers, from where we get the food, we get our food. That is the most important, because without food we cannot survive. And food is grown in the field, and that is using the soil. So the most important application of soil is food production. But the thing is, we are not concerned here with food production, all these things. Such things are to be studied by an agriculture engineering student or BSc Agri student or some other students who is related with farms and fields. But we are concerned with construction field. Our civil engineering deals with the construction field. So here, what is the application of soil in construction, that we are going to study in detail here. Okay, when I take the syllabus in introduction class, I will tell you. So now coming here, soil has different meaning. किसको कैसा लगता है, किसी को किस काम से आता है, he will define. जैसा कि एक अंधे को आप हाथी बताओ, सूंड को पकड़ा तो उसको अलग लगता, जब उसके दुम को पकड़ता उसको अलग लगता, उसके कान को पकड़ा तो उसको अलग तरह से लगता, वैसा ही डिपेंडिंग ऑन द यूज ऑफ सॉइल इट चेंजेस फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन. It changes from person, person to person. For agriculturist, soil is different. For geologist, soil is different. Suppose somebody is in rock field or this what called mines field. For him, that is geology. It is different. So for engineer, construction engineer, it is different. So what is soil in geology? Suppose if you get a big stone, no. They will a big stone. So in engineers, for civil engineering, if you take a big stone or rock, that also will consider as soil only. In general definitions, soil means, even in general also, soil has different meanings. Mitti mein gaya, like just like we tell, there are some different meaning of mitti is there. So soil has different meaning depending on the profession or the field. For the agriculturist, soil is the substance enlisting on the earth surface which grows and develop plant life. So for growing the plant life, whatever the fertile soil is needed, no, that is very important here. The soil should be fertile, then only it is useful for agriculturist. समझ में आ रहा आपको? देखिए बहुत से जगह जहां पर जमीन सही नहीं रहती, दूसरे तरफ से फर्टाइल सॉइल लाके फिर हम पैदा क्या करते हैं, फसल डालते हैं वहां पर. सो दिस वॉज द थिंग. सो मीन्स फॉर अ एग्रीकल्चर सॉइल इज अ सब्सटेंस विच इज यूज्ड फॉर ग्रोइंग एंड डेवलपिंग अ प्लांट और क्रॉप, वॉट एवर इट इज. सो व्हेन इट कम्स टू जियोलॉजिस्ट, सो फॉर द जियोलॉजिस्ट, सॉइल इज द मटेरियल ऑन रिलेटिव देन सरफेस जोन विद इन विच रूट्स अकर एंड ऑल द रेस्ट ऑफ द क्रस्ट इज ग्रेप अंडर टर्म रॉक इरेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ इट हार्डनेस. मतलब एक सॉइल, मतलब एक पर्टिकुलर थिकनेस तक उसको सॉइल बोलते हैं. जियोलॉजी वाले, जियोलॉजी पढ़े आप, जियोलॉजी को डिफाइन करें ना, अंडर अर्थ के क्रस्ट को कैसे कैसे डिफाइन करते जाते आप. तो जियोलॉजी के लिए जो टॉप सरफेस है उसको ना सॉइल बोलता है, पर्टिकुलर लेज तक. उसके बाद नीचे जो भी है, चाहे कैसा भी रहने दो, नरम रहने दो या आप सख्त रहने दो, व्हाटएवर इट इज. So he will consider it as rock means that is different. Up to certain different only geology consider it as what I was telling is soil. Now to an engineer, means civil engineer, of course, soil is unsaturated or co-cemented deposit of material and or organic particle covering large portion of earth's crust. It includes widely different material like boulders and gravel cells. Means even a rock is there, a boulder is there, that is also considered as soil. That is also considered as soil for a geotechnical engineering. Unsaturated cemented deposit of material, whichever is there, that is even some rock is there, earth crust is there, that is also soil. Soil manje far minute aslela je mati hai tela soil manu naka tumhi as an engineer, as a geotechnical engineer. Ek motta rock rahu de, khada rahu de, dagad rahu de, that is also considered as soil only. Of course, in classification of soil, you will study in detail those different things, that is different. So in this way, soil has been defined in varieties of ways for different professions based on the profession of the person. The soil is different. A soil for agriculture is different. A soil is geologist is different. A soil for general people is different. And a soil is different for an engineer. So keep it in your mind. Soil doesn't mean what you get. जो तो आप मिट्टी को समझ रहे हैं जो बहुत minute है वो ऐसा नहीं है. खड़ा असल तरी ते soil मध्ये चेनार मोटे दगड़ असल तरी ते soil मध्ये चेनार. Of course we will classify that in different way. That is different thing. But soil depends on person to differ from person to person. Soil differs from person to person. Got it? So now, then after defining soil, then we will define what is soil mechanics. What is soil mechanics? So what is mechanics? Mechanics is the study of forces. When it is in static, it is statics. When it is in motion, it is dynamics. Like this you have studied. Mechanics also you have studied in detail. Isn't it? So now, soil mechanics means a mechanics which deals with soil. So you have studied mechanics in first year. Then you have studied solid mechanics, SOM, structural analysis. So there you have studied the mechanics of solids. Mechanics of concrete, mechanics of steel, mechanics of wood. Okay, so then you have studied fluid mechanics. Means fluid means, of course, we take water, but it is not necessarily water. It can be petrol, diesel, milk, anything fluid. So you have studied mechanics of fluid also. It is fluid mechanics. What my idea? So now we are studying is soil mechanics. Once again, I will tell you, especially for A section students, this subject is at the beginning. So please, I will go in detail as interest you show. So more the interest you show, more in detail I will teach you. And right from basics, you make it fundamentally perfect. So you prepare for GATE simultaneously this time itself. Not only university exam, for the GATE also you prepare. Got the idea? So now it is in the beginning, no? So now, ata ABCD pasun tumhi soil mechanics shiklala. You are in LKG now. So you can learn all the things, but once you, miss the idea starting chapter, no. If you don't know what is voids ratio, what is porosity, then nothing you can study in the future. So that's why I'm telling you, strength is so low. Near about 140 students are there, and only 45 students you people are attending. Don't understand why you people don't. So if you won't show, maybe 10-20%. Maybe having some network problem, all these things. Our 10-20 students are having some personal works, functions, all these things. But at least out of 140, 80-90 students should be there. So you people, when you don't show interest, means how the teacher can show it? For the formality sake also, you will complete the syllabus and you people also study for formality sake only. Okay, so soil mechanics is at the beginning. Please start from the right ABCD, whatever the things I'm telling you. Okay, today itself I will start the actual syllabus. Of course, this is also syllabus, but this is all theory. You can read it yourself also. But next things you may not study, you cannot be study yourself. Okay, so now mechanics of soil we are studying here. Means when soil is in rest, what are the forces acting on it? How it behaves it? And one basic thing I will tell you, in concrete or solid mechanics or fluid mechanics, you will come across tensile force, compressive force very much. But shear strength is very much important in soil mechanics. Soil fails maximum by shear only. So in soil, shear kasa rata hai? Ek dusre cha ragdat jata hai. Shear stress. Padhe na aap log? Modulus of rigidity. Kainchi hai dekho. Kainchi se aap paper ko kaato. It is the example of shear stress. So maximum jo strength hai soil mein, wo shear strength hai. Shear strength का होना बहुत जरूरी है. ओके, सो सॉइल मैकेनिक्स मींस मैकेनिक्स ऑफ सॉइल वी स्टडी. दिस इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज जियोटेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग आल्सो. दिस इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज जियोटेक्निकल इंजीनियरिंग आल्सो. ओके, एंड दिस इज द यंगेस्ट ब्रांच ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग. एज आई टोल्ड यू, सिविल इंजीनियरिंग इज द ओल्डेस्ट ब्रांच कंपेयरिंग टू इलेक्ट्रिकल मैकेनिकल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कंप्यूटर. बट इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग the soil mechanics is very new one, and recent developments have taken, I think, in 25-30 years. What when I was the student, no, the things which I studied are very much different nowadays. A lot of advancement has been made when soil mechanics is concerned. A lot of advancement has been made when soil mechanics is concerned. So now, what is the soil mechanics? So according to, I told you, no, general definition is mechanics of soil. What are the different forces are acting on the soil, how it acts, how it behaves? That detailed study what we make is called soil mechanics. Okay, soil mechanics, you should have the knowledge of fluid mechanics also here. You should have the knowledge of solid mechanics also here, because soil is the combination of solid and liquid, water also, fluid also. Generally soil madhe pani pan rahnar na, pani pan rahnar, solid particles pan rahnar. That's why solid mechanics, so to study the soil mechanics, you should have the fundamental basic knowledge of fluid mechanics as well as solid mechanics. And according to Terzaghi, remember Terzaghi, you can call father, grandfather, great grandfather, anything of soil mechanics. Whatever the improvements has been done in soil mechanics, I think near about more than half credit goes to Terzaghi only. Terzaghi's inventions, Terzaghi's, whatever the discoveries regarding soil are there, are very, very, very important. Are very important, and he has contributed in each and everything. That's why he's called father of soil mechanics. Okay, so what he says, what is the definition of soil mechanics? According to him, soil mechanics is the application of laws of mechanics and hydraulics to engineering problems dealing with sediments and other unconsolidated accumulation of solid particles produced by the mechanical and chemical disintegration of rock, regardless of whether not containing admixture of organic constituent. So this is the definition of soil mechanics according to Terzaghi. Luckily, fortunately, unfortunately, whatever you say, some of the syllabus has been deleted. That is the origin of soil, how the soil is formed. This portion has been deleted. This portion has been neglected in soil mechanics. So, but it is not the case. In gate examination, it is there. Soil kaisa banta? Ek bahut bada patthar hai. Ye apne aap jagah. Kab tak apne aap jagah rehta? Kabhi na kabhi usme ek din, do din ka mat socho aap. Patthar bhi saalon ke baad kahi na kahi usme disintegration hota. Patthar se kankar bante. Bade rock se kankar bante. Kankar kya banta? Pani aaye jab behke jata. कभी फिजिकल वेदरिंग से जाता, कभी केमिकल से हो जाता, तो वो पत्थर क्या जाता, फिर डिसइंटीग्रेट होता, फिर डिसइंटीग्रेट इंटीग्रेट होते होते वो मिट्टी हो जाता. सो दिस इज द हाउ द ओरिजिन, व्हाट इज द हिस्ट्री ऑफ सॉइल, व्हाट इज द ओरिजिन ऑफ सॉइल, हाउ सॉइल इज फॉर्म्ड, प्लीज गो थ्रू इन डिटेल. This is in the gate examination, and mostly one question, one marks question you will get on origin of soil in most question papers. So how the soil is formed, here I cannot tell you, it is not for the university syllabus, but it is for the gate syllabus. Earlier it was there. So what is the soil mechanics according to theory is there? It is the application of laws of mechanics and hydraulics, both application of mechanics, that is solid mechanics, and hydraulics, because soil contains water. So two engineering problems dealing with the sediment and other, because of the sedimentation, because of consolidation, because of all these accumulation of these rocks, sand, whatever, silt, whatever you call, it will takes place. This will disintegrate again it will flow. So it is a continuous process, maybe using the weather, may not be using the weather. And this process, this application is called soil mechanics. Soil mechanics. So basically, I will tell you, whatever the forces acting on soil after forming, of course, after its formation, we study in detail, including the hydraulics. So hydraulics also plays an important role in soil mechanics. So this is called soil mechanics. This is called soil mechanics. The term soil engineering is currently used to cover a much wider scope, compiling that it is a practical science rather than partially fundamental. As I told you, it is not a fundamental or mathematical science. It is practical science also. Nowadays, a lot of research is going on. Still, it is there. And I will again and tell you, those who want to go for higher studies after your BTech, MTech, PhD, whatever you do, please choose this field. There are very less hands in soil mechanics. Everybody goes for structural engineering only. Very less colleges are there where you will get the MTech soil mechanics, geotech, and there here it is there. Okay, so this is all about soil mechanics. One more part is there of soil mechanics or geotechnical engineering that you will study in next semester. That is the sixth semester, and this is called foundation engineering. Foundation engineering is what? Foundation engineering is a branch of civil engineering which is associated with design, construction, maintenance, and regulation of footing, foundation wall, pile foundation, caisson, and all other structural member. All other structural member which form the foundation of the building and other engineering structure. Other engineering structure. So the most important part, now I will tell you, we are not concerned in geology, we are not concerned in agriculturists. What we want is, we want to study foundation engineering. And to study the foundation engineering, basic knowledge of soil mechanics is very, very, very important. Hamara maximum ka main kaam soil mechanics kahan use hota? Foundation engineering. Because without foundation, a construction cannot stand. You are aware of this one. Aap chahe road banao, bridge banao, dam banao, building banao, mall banao, takis banao, college banao, hospital banao. For every construction, foundation is needed. And this is the main application of soil mechanics for civil engineers. Foundation mazboot hona. This is a common thing we will get after in our local language or daily language also we use. Mazboot paya rana, paya bolte Hindi mein. Foundation must be strong. The more the foundation strong, the more the building is stable. This is the thing, you know it very well. This is the basic thing. इसको कोई बोलने की जरूरत नहीं है. तो उस फाउंडेशन के बारे में हम डिटेल में पढ़ते, कैसा डिजाइन करना, कैसा कंस्ट्रक्शन करना, किस टाइप का कट्टी, मिट्टी किस काम को आता. देखिए, नाउ टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ ब्लैक कॉटन सॉइल. ब्लैक कॉटन सॉइल इज वेरी मच, इट इज द फॉन्ड ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरिस्ट. बहुत अच्छा लगता है उनको, जो उपजाऊ जमीन रहना, नरम मिट्टी रहना, हाँ, काली मिट्टी रहना, तो उसमें अच्छा फसल होता ब्लैक कॉटन सॉइल में. बट इट इज अगेंस्ट फॉर सिविल इंजीनियर्स. सिविल इंजीनियर, अ परफेक्ट सिविल इंजीनियर, नेवर फेवर ब्लैक कॉटन सॉइल फॉर फाउंडेशन, इजंट इट? सो for civil engineer, so most of the application, maximum application of soil mechanics is foundation. I will tell you, almost all 80%. Of course, while constructing these pavements, tunnels, or sometimes earth dam, you may need the knowledge of soil mechanics. But foundation engineering, the main part. So the more, in general term also we use, no, the more the foundation is strong, your superstructure is stable. You know the superstructure. Above the ground level, whatever the construction is there, it is superstructure. Below is the foundation. And foundation portion supports the superstructure. So foundation is the main important part. Suppose if your soil is, hard, stable, then there is no need of any knowledge of civil engineering. Just like in my place, in my place, everybody is engineer because there the soil is very hard. No need of any knowledge of soil mechanics or engineering is needed there. But in your place, Pandharpur, wherever I have seen, the most of the soil is soft only. So you have to go deep for foundation. So more the deeper you go, more the stable construction you can give. And at that time, the knowledge of civil engineering is very, very important. And in civil engineering, again, soil mechanics is important. Where the water table lies, what is the effect of water table there? What is the bearing capacity of soil is there? So to know the bearing capacity, again, we know what is its cohesion, what is its angle of shearing resistance, what is its permeability, what is its, all these are basic properties of soil. If you are perfect in all these things, if you are perfect in all these properties, then only you can study foundation engineering in detail. So of course, from academic point of view, part one is very, very, very important. Whatever the things you studied in fifth semester. But when it comes to the practical life, so part B is a very important. पार्ट बी फाउंडेशन इंजीनियरिंग हम जितना भी सॉइल मैकेनिक्स पढ़ते हैं ये टोटली फाउंडेशन के लिए पढ़ते हैं याद रखो ऑफ कोर्स कुछ और अभी एप्लीकेशन है सर आप बोल रहे क्या सिर्फ हम फाउंडेशन के लिए पढ़ते इट इज नथिंग लाइक दैट ऑफ कोर्स सम अदर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ सॉइल मैकेनिक्स आर आल्सो देयर बट रिमेंबर फाउंडेशन इंजीनियरिंग इज द बेसिक थिंग एंड इन सेकंड सेमेस्टर व्हेन यू गो फॉर हायर सेमेस्टर आई मीन नेक्स्ट क्लास नेक्स्ट सेमेस्टर So remember, there you will study in detail about foundation engineering. There are shallow foundation, there are deep foundation. What is shallow foundation? What is deep foundation? In deep foundation, what are pile foundation? What is caisson? All these things, what is footing? What is the difference between footing and foundation? All these things in detail you will study in. All these things in detail you will study in second semester. So I hope now, till now, you are clear with what is soil, what is soil mechanics, and what is foundation engineering. What is foundation engineering? Got the idea? Okay. Now, coming to the next part, that is the field of soil mechanics. Field of soil mechanics. So where the application of soil mechanics is needed? Where the field application of soil mechanics is needed. The first thing is foundation design and construction. First is foundation design and construction. So foundation is an important element of civil engineering structure. Every structure, koi bhi structure rahne do, bridge rahne do, highway rahne do, tunnel rahne do, canal rahne do, dam rahne do, aap ready-made laddu ke jaisa bana ke nahi rakh sakte. Niche aapko foundation dena padta hai, fir uske baad hi upar aap construct kar sakte. तो फाउंडेशन आपका जितना स्ट्रॉन्ग रहेगा और फाउंडेशन जानने के लिए आपको क्या मालूम होना चाहिए बेयरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द सॉइल दिस यू विल स्टडी इन डिटेल दैट इज यू नीड नॉट वरी अबाउट दैट सो बेसिकली द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एप्लीकेशन ऑफ सॉइल मैकेनिक्स इज फाउंडेशन डिजाइन एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन फाउंडेशन ओनली सो वॉट इज फाउंडेशन इज अगेन डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट शालो फाउंडेशन एंड डीप फाउंडेशन Shallow foundation means where the depth of foundation is very less. It is used for small buildings or where the soil is very strong. Shallow foundation is okay. But when the soil is weak, even the soil is strong, but if you want to construct a 20-story building, 25, आप तो देखो पता नहीं इतने बड़े बड़े इतने ऊंचे बिल्डिंग हो रहे कि हम सोच भी नहीं सकते हाँ तो ऐसे बिल्डिंग आप बना रहे आपका सॉइल कितना भी स्ट्रांग रहने दो नीचे तो यू हैव टू प्रोवाइड फाउंडेशन फॉर देयर, फाउंडेशन फॉर देयर. अगर से आप वीक सॉइल के ऊपर फाउंडेशन बनाए और अच्छा फाउंडेशन नहीं दिए, तो देखिए आप बहुत से रोड्स देखे होंगे सीसी के क्रैक्स आ जाते, या आप दीवारें देखे होंगे क्रैक्स आ जाते, स्पेशली ये जो बाउंड्री वॉल रहते ये क्रैक्स आ जाते इसमें, बिकॉज देयर द फाउंडेशन इज नॉट गुड, देयर फाउंडेशन इज नॉट गुड. सो वन ऑफ द बेस्ट एप्लीकेशन ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग इज फाउंडेशन, सॉइल मैकेनिक्स इज फाउंडेशन इंजीनियरिंग. बहुत आप डिटेल में इंटरेस्ट से पढ़ सकते. Still, I am telling you, you develop the interest in this subject. This carries weightage of 14 to 18 marks in GATE exam. Remember, it carries 14 to 18 marks in this one. 14 to 18 marks in this one. Got it? So now, next is a pavement design. What is the next application of soil engineering? It is the pavement design. Pavement design means this road पे जो बनाते आप, अब तो देखो सीसी रोड कितने मजबूत हो रहे हैं आपका, ये संगोला का रोड, मंगलवेड़ा का रोड, सब सीसी हो गए. पर तो सीसी रोड हम लोग समझ रहे हैं आप, सीसी मतलब सीमेंट कॉन्क्रीट के रोड, ये डांबर के रोड नहीं जो आप ये यूज कर रहे हैं. पहले तो डांबर के रोड चलते थे, लेकिन अब सीसी रोड हो रहे. तो ये सीसी रोड क्या है, सीमेंट कॉन्क्रीट से बनाते. तो ये अब तो मेन हाईवेज के लिए भी, देखो सांगोला का रोड कोई छोटा नहीं है आपका, देखिए पूरा सीसी रोड है. वहां पर भी देयर आल्सो दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग रेनफोर्समेंट टू मेक दैट वन स्ट्रॉन्ग. सो देयर हियर आल्सो एप्लीकेशन ऑफ सॉइल मैकेनिक्स प्लेज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट व्हाइल डिजाइनिंग पेवमेंट्स आल्सो. सो नॉलेज ऑफ सॉइल प्रॉपर्टीज, its strength, stability, all these are helpful for constructing pavement or poor soil by stabilizing them. So next important application of soil mechanics is pavement design. Next important of soil mechanics is pavement design. The first one is foundation design and construction, and second is pavement design. But it third is डिजाइन ऑफ अंडरग्राउंड स्ट्रक्चर एंड अर्थ रिटेनिंग स्ट्रक्चर. अर्थ रिटेनिंग स्ट्रक्चर मालूम है आपको, बहुत से रिटेनिंग वाल देखे आप, आपको पता नहीं है, आप जाओ सोलापुर के रास्ते में बहुत से बन रहे, मिट्टी है समझो, मिट्टी को रोकना है हमको, अर्थ प्रेशर पड़े ना तो एक वॉल कंस्ट्रक्ट करते रिटेनिंग वॉल, वो मिट्टी को पूरा दबाता है, वो मिट्टी के तरफ से उसके ऊपर एक्टिव प्रेशर पैसिव प्रेशर ये पड़े. नहीं नहीं सॉरी सॉरी सॉरी, आप लोग नहीं पढ़े अभी, आगे पढ़ते ही. सो इट इज एन अर्थ रिटेनिंग स्ट्रक्चर रहते, तो उस अर्थ रिटेनिंग स्ट्रक्चर में क्या मिट्टी है, किस टाइप का है, कैसा हम रिटेनिंग वॉल डिजाइन करना. हाँ अंडरग्राउंड स्ट्रक्चर है बहुत से स्टोरेज के लिए. सो दोज ऑल दीज थिंग्स प्लीज, शीट पाइल वॉल्स है ये सब, क्या है मैं आपको बताता हूँ. और आप व्हेनेवर द थिंग्स, शीट पाइल वॉल है, फटाक से गूगल में शीट पाइल वॉल मारो, निकाल के देखो, रिटेनिंग वॉल है निकाल के देखो, ये क्यूरियोसिटी आपके अंदर आना, हो सकता है आप खुद जाकर ना देख सके हो, हम लोग ऑफलाइन क्लास नहीं ले सक रहे, ऑनलाइन है, लेकिन यू यूटिलाइज इट, गूगल में जाके यू सी क्रिकेटर्स हीरोज ऑल दीज थिंग्स, इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट वन यू सी दिस, व्हाट इज द रिटेनिंग वॉल, एटलीस्ट यू शुड हैव द आइडिया व्हाट इज रिटेनिंग वॉल, देन व्हाट आर अंडरग्राउंड स्ट्रक्चर्स, टनल क्या है. हाँ तो ऑल फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ अंडरग्राउंड स्ट्रक्चर्स, जैसे लगे अंडरग्राउंड स्ट्रक्चर मतलब नीचे टनल पाइपलाइन बना रहे, रिटेनिंग वॉल है, शीट पाइल वॉल है, ये तो हम डिटेल में पढ़ते, छोड़ो शीट पाइल वॉल क्या है, कैसा डिजाइन करना. सो नॉलेज ऑफ सॉइल मैकेनिक्स इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट इन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स आल्सो, इन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स आल्सो. एंड व्हेन इट इज डिजाइन ऑफ एम्बैकमेंट एंड एक्सकेवेशन, हाँ एक्सकेवेशन भी करते हैं आप, साइड में एम्बैकमेंट भी बनाते, देर ऑल्सो द नॉलेज ऑफ दिस सिविल इंजीनियरिंग इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, जितना डीप रहेगा, ज्यादा एक्सकेवेशन करने का तो मिट्टी गिरते जाता, तो वहां पर आपको प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मिट्टी बहुत जरूरी है, आप ब्रेसिंग कितना देना क्या नहीं देना ये तो बहुत दूर की बात है. आपको फिलहाल यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड नाउ व्हाट आर द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ सॉइल मैकेनिक्स, what are the application of soil mechanics. Got it? Now Next is design of earth dam. This is a very 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 important. आप लोग पढ़ चुके हैं ग्रेविटी डैम क्या है, अर्थ डैम क्या है. कैन एनीबडी टेल मी व्हाट इज द अर्थ डैम? अर्थ डैम क्या है और ग्रेविटी डैम क्या है, ये दोनों का डिफरेंस क्या है? कोई पढ़े ना आप लोग, मेरे ख्याल से वाटर रिसोर्सेज इंजीनियरिंग पढ़े आप, फलमारी सर पढ़ाए आपको, जगदाड़े सर कोई तो पढ़ाए होंगे. सो यू पीपल हैव स्टडीड इट. सो अर्थ डैम मीन्स, अर्थ डैम टोटली जो लोकली अवेलेबल सॉइल रहता है ना वो यूज करके कंस्ट्रक्ट करते हैं. मैसनरी उसनरी से ज्यादा भी जो लोकली मिट्टी रहता आपको, उसको लोकली जो बोल्डर्स रहते हैं उसको उसको लेके हम अर्थ डैम कंस्ट्रक्ट करते हैं. एंड व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग द लोकली अवेलेबल मटेरियल देन यू शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ इट्स डेंसिटी, प्लास्टिसिटी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक एंड इट्स स्पेसिफिक ग्रेविटी, इट्स पार्टिकल साइज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, इट्स ग्रेडेशन ऑफ सॉइल, इट्स परमेबिलिटी. ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू. यू शुड नो ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ सॉइल. सो दीज आर द वेरियस, दीज आर द वेरियस एप्लीकेशन ऑफ soil mechanics. These are the various application of soil mechanics. So you should be familiar with what is soil. So of course it is different from, अच्छा इसके बाद एक छोटा ब्रेक ले लो चार दो चार मिनट का, then we can resume. So soil is different for different professional fields. For agriculturist soil is different, for geologist soil is different, and how it is concerned with a civil engineer or geotechnical engineer, that also you should know. Soil in geotechnical engineering doesn't mean that whatever you find in the ground, a boulder, sand is also soil. अरे sand कैसा मिट्टी हो सकता बोलते आप? No, sand in geotechnical engineering, sand is also soil. Sand is cohesionless soil. Clay is also soil. Of course, clay को तो आप soil बोलते हैं, लेकिन sand को आप general language में soil नहीं बोलते आप. But sand is also a part of soil. सैंड एंड क्ले, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. सैंड क्या है? कोहेजनलेस सॉइल. सैंड क्या है? याद रखो ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. और क्ले क्या है? कोहेजिव सॉइल है.